So coming into a game like tonight after seeing what Lakers were do last night in Dallas, if you watched that game at all, what have you seen the way that team is looking right now?
They're playing great. Obviously, they won that tournament, in-season tournament. They went 7-0. That's hard to do regardless of playing, or I'm sorry, in-season, regular season. I mean, that's winning 7 in a row in this league's hard. So they're playing great basketball. LeBron and AD, obviously, at the head of that. They're playing super well. So we got to take care of those guys, protect the paint, you know, keep AD off the glass, keep him off the free throw line. That's where he's scoring a lot of his points. So we got to be on our point tonight.
What have you found to be the positives and negatives of the two big lineup that you guys have obviously gone away from recently?
Well, I think if we were shooting it a little bit better, I think it would have worked better. You know, the negative right now is spacing, so that's why big reason why we went back to one big out there starting the game instead of two. So, you know, at the end of the day, this is a make or miss league. It's shooting. You have to be able to shoot, space the floor, especially if you got two bigs out there. So we got to do a better job of that. Hopefully we can get back to that lineup a little bit more.
Is there anything you're like whispering or telling Victor about kind of balance of physicality being the only thing out there?
Sometimes, you know, everybody knows they're not going to, if you try to challenge Victor straight up at the rim, you're going to lose. So they're getting into his body. They're like Jeff Green the other night, you know, threw the ball right into his face. So just to watch out for stuff like that. And if he can, and Pop said it too, if he can take that initial hit and know that it's coming and then still be ready, he'll be fine. I mean, he's already protecting the rim unbelievably.
I think he's second on the team in drawing charges. And just shows, you know, he'll mix it up. I mean, he's not afraid.
Yeah, no, he's not afraid of contact. He's from day one, he hasn't been afraid of really anything. So. Yeah, I'm not surprised.
You guys like that he doesn't look to the refs for help too. He just goes about his business, it seems like.
I honestly haven't noticed, but I mean, he's very next play guy. You can see it in his reactions, even if he makes a mistake or, like you said, doesn't get a good call. He doesn't seem to dwell on it. He's very positive moving forward. That's good for us.
Did you see his ankle turn sideways in that game the other night?
Yeah, we just talked about it, and I didn't even see that it twisted until I saw the video, but I just saw, I mean, you can tell, like, when a leg hits the ground, it's straight, and it's something that just didn't look right. So, but when I saw the video, that's unbelievable that he just...
He said he didn't even know it happened.
That's in today. He's like, it's not sore, so... It's crazy.
Is everybody else going to start doing his stretches now, I guess?
Hell no.
That's too much.
Nah. Testament to how he takes care of his body, you know. I mean, I've said it from day one. He does everything he needs to in the weight room. He doesn't take that part for granted. So that's probably a result of that.
How bad are you guys going to miss Charles Bassey? And how bad do you feel for him for two seasons in a row?
Yeah, he's battled, man. He's been through a lot. Had a great year last year, and then that got cut short again, and he was playing great this year, and then again that happened. So, but he's resilient. He's come back from stuff before. He's a very positive guy, but we're definitely going to miss him, man.
Is he up here today? Have you seen him? Have you talked?
Yeah, he was here for shoot around.
How's he doing?
Seems to be good. He smiled today when I talked to him, so that's important.
Exactly.
So.
Obviously, amid the struggles the team's kind of gone through, how big is it for you guys to get three home games in a row and just kind of be back at home in front of the crowd?
It's good, man. This crowd does a lot for us. Their energy, their support every night, it's huge, and we definitely need it right now, and hopefully we get one tonight.
How do you guys continue with 17 in a row, seeing Charles go down? How do you continue to stay positive and keep moving forward?
What choice do we have? You know what I mean? It's the NBA. We got the next man up. There's another game every other day. So what's happened has happened. We can't look at that as something that, you know, people are going to feel bad for us. You know, we can't feel sorry for ourselves. So we just got to move on, keep playing.
So just back to the Houston game for a second. 82 points. On the other hand, the least by you in this season. On the other hand, the game was pretty tight even till the end. Are you are you afraid of this situation that, you know, it was only 82 points? Or are you just like focusing on developing the progress that was just started by this game, this new lineup?
5 for 41. That's why, I mean, you can't shoot that bad and expect to put points on the board. So one of our best defensive games of the year just so happened to be our worst shooting night of the year. So stuff happens like that, man. But we hang our hat on the fact that we're getting better on defense, and that'll carry us to more wins than shooting. So we're excited about that.
When a number's that absurd, 5 for 41, does it make it easier just to throw it out? Just like that's
It's not easy throwing any of these losses out, but I mean, I don't know. It's hurts a little bit more knowing we did so well defensively, and we just, I mean, guys that usually hit shots, even if they miss four or five in a row, their averages, the law of average is going to play out. They're going to hit more, and that night it just didn't happen.
So. With LeBron being a game time decision, Devin was saying that, you know, it's going to be a battle of the bigs, even knowing how big that team is.
Yeah.
Does that kind of put you guys in any type of mindset? Devin was saying, I'm ready to play, so it doesn't really necessarily matter. But you guys look at that at all as if whether or not LeBron's playing or not?
I mean, it definitely changes the game plan for them and for us a little bit if he doesn't play. But at the same time, we have to start winning games. So we have a sense of urgency regardless.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Sorry, my fault.